on Science in Action. I would like to say that this institution was established in the memory of Justice Mehar Chand Mahajan, the third Chief Justice of India. He was also the Prime Minister of Kashmir. And in 2018, the college completed 50 years. And Honorable President of India, Shri Ramnath Kovind, visited the campus. Like you saw, we have been performing excellently in the field of Swachhata. And I would like to share that in 2018, we were also given Institution Innovation Cell by MHRD. And we are also working under Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. We have adopted 5 villages under Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. And we are working in direct coordination with Ministry of Human Resource Development under ODF, making India open defecation free. This year, we got 173 Punjab University positions, top 10 positions. All innovations, you will agree, the result of some small idea. So these ideas that came out today, they would have remained in the minds of their creators had they not been given chance to generate these. So this is an excellent initiative of the department. I must appreciate it.
A very warm good morning to all of you. And to all the present, those who have come on the occasion of inauguration of workshop on Science on Action. I have observed certain things with respect to the R&D innovation program of Government of India. The Global Innovative Index, which has submitted a report or published a report in 2019. There, the Indian rank has jumped remarkably. Is it because of our own effort, or is it because of the FDIs which are taking place in India? That way we have to look at. Now, if it is happening because of FDIs, then you have to look at that what we have to do to increase the FDI in India from the point of view of increasing the R&D initiative in the country. If you look at the countries, small countries like Vietnam, Kenya, now they are able to increase their spending on R&D. Whereas when we look at our country, we have not increased the spending on R&D. It is still stagnant at a rate of 0.6 or 0.7% of the total GDP. The main reason what I have observed from my experience in NIPER is the people, those who are doing the research, they do not have the orientation toward converting the research into a product. They have the orientation that, okay, fine, we will get a publication, we will get a patent, and from patent, we will get a promotion. That is the only aim of all the inventors, all the scientists, those who are working. If you are interested in doing the research, try to look at the society, try to look at the conversion of that research into the product.
Whenever we meet people, there are always 3 P's which I follow in principle. It's always about people, purpose, and the project. My funding agency here, you have the banner, you can see the collaborators are ICER Pune. You have the National Center for Cell Science, who were also my collaborators in my PhD. So they carry out niche research, which includes making of artificial skin, eye, kidney, and a lot of cells. You know, niche research happens at NCCS. In fact, Pune is like the Oxford of India, okay? So you just name an institute and it's just there in Pune. So it's like, a spectrum of a large amount of research that occurs there. The project is obviously Manav, which is data annotation, or the Human Atlas Initiative. And the people, my dear friends, are you, okay? So there is people, yes, there is a project, and there is a purpose which you will be annotating data.
We are in an era of disruptive innovation. Do you know what is disruptive innovation? No? It's about challenging status quo. It's about challenging the order. And today I'm here to disrupt the mindset. You need not undermine your skills and expertise. If you girls think you have the potential to make a change, you definitely have it. But it's all about coming out of your comfort zone. So it's about you. If you realize today you are empowered enough, you have ideas, and you can build on those ideas, and we help you build on those ideas, and we mentor you in your journey towards becoming an entrepreneur. What do you see there? On the other side, Durga. And if you look at this picture, if you have to give one word to womanhood, so what would be that one word? Multitasking. Never ever think that you're weak or feeble. When we say you have intellect, and if you, we believe that you are completely, completely empowered and enabled. It's all about realizing.
I express my thanks to Principal Ma'am for giving me this opportunity to interact with you guys. This event, which is being organized at the time when this country is really gearing up for next stage. You've already listened to our Prime Minister also. Make in India initiative is one of the strongest initiative what we all must look into and be part of it. And the onus is on to you guys, to the young minds, because that is the need of the hour. Definitely teachers are very important part of that process, but it is the ignited mind that needs to be channelized toward making this country a proud country. I was reading somewhere, if you have a problem which is around 12 component problem, the answer to that problem is 720 ways. And you know who decoded that part? A young mind like you. So you keep on increasing the number of those problems, the number of ways also increase. The idea is to look beyond. Aapko idea lene ke liye kahin bahut dur jaane ki zarurat nahi hai. Find things around. Some of the initiative Department of Science and Technology has come up with an idea called Technology Enabling Center. So around 109 different universities, they competed for it. And Punjab University was one of the university out of 109 that around 4 got selected. And we were one of them to got that Technology Enabling Center.